Hello students, today the new chapter will start, Introduction to Flash. Okay, before that first we'll discuss what is Flash. I think everybody want to animate any pictures or any graphics or any objects. So that can be done by using Flash software. Okay, so Flash is an animation software which allows us to create not only simple animations but also complex interactive web applications. We can also make our Flash applications media rich by adding pictures, sound and video also. Okay, let us discuss how to start Flash. First go to All Programs. Okay, then click on Macromedia Flash. So Macromedia Flash software, dialog box will be opened and you select on Flash document option, then click on OK buttons. So in front of you the flash document window will be appeared. So now I'll tell you the different components of the Flash, or we can say the Flash interface also. Okay, so let us discuss. So the first component is stage. Is the rectangular area where we can place graphic content including vector art, text box, buttons. So whatever the drawings you want to do, we can do in this white color portion, that is known as stage. So next we'll discuss about the timeline. Timeline organizes and controls a document contain over time in layers and frames, like films, flash documents divide length of time into frames. Okay, so that means already I have shown once, you can see it also, layers. Okay, that like multiple film strips taken on a top of one another, each containing different image that appears on the stage. Okay, so generally this timeline having three components are there. One is playhead, one is frame, and one is layers. Okay, one is playhead and one is frame and one is layers. Next we'll discuss about the panels. It helps us to view, organize and change elements of a movie. Panel can be grouped together by convenience. Okay, particular layout of panels can be saved and recalled another time. Next is toolbar. The tools in the toolbar that helps to draw, paint, select, modify artwork, it is just same as the other software also. Okay, next is document properties. Document properties can be done by right clicking on the stage. You first right click anywhere in the stage window and select the document properties from the pop-up menu. Okay, so the dialog box will open, the document property dialog box will appear, and in this dialog box just you change whatever you want, just like dimension, width, okay, then your background color, frame rate, everything you change if you want, then click on OK button. So in this dialog box few important terms are given, just let us see. One is dimension. What is the purpose of the dimension? Actually that is called the width and height of the document. So generally default movie dimension are 550 pixel and wide by 400 pixel high. Okay, so next is one is given, that is called match printer. It sets the stage size to match the print area defined in the page setup dialog box. One is given match contents. It is used after we have set up the objects on the stage. Clicking on this button will immediately resize the stage so that the objects are centered on the stage with an equal margin around all four sides. Next one is background color. Background color can also be changed, and it helps to set the background color of the movie also. And this color will apply to the entire movie. We cannot use different background color in the different section of the movie. That is not possible. Then one is given ruler unit. It is used to set the unit of measure we prefer to work with. Okay. Next is given frame rate. The frame rate is the number of animated frames to be played per second. So 12 frames per second is a good speed for wave playback. Another one is make default. If we want to have the changes we have made to be applied to all the subsequent new movies, then we need to click this button so we can change the default again at any point of time. So students, today we covered the introduction to Flash, how to start Flash, okay, and what are the different components of the Flash. And next we'll discuss, in the next modules we'll discuss the different tools used in the toolbar. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.